Oh, hey best friends. I want to start by saying thank you so much to my new subscribers. It means so much to me. If you haven't done so yet, please hit the subscribe button. You know, Valentine's Day is just around the corner, and that's the perfect time to tell your pupper, or your mommy daddy, or your crush that you love them. Lucky for you, I have 4 tips to help you have a successful Valentine's Day. Then, I put them to the test when I ask my crush out on a date at the end of the video. So, without further ado, let's get into it. So tip number 1 is look the part. This means you need to take a tubby no matter how much you hate them. And you have to dress to impress. I won't bore you with footage of me taking a tubby, but if you'd like to see that, leave a comment below. I will, however, impress you with my fancy new bow tie. What do you think? Get a close up. You can never be overdressed, so wear something nice. Tip number 2, buy flowers. I repeat, buy flowers. I went with half a dozen of fresh, long-stem roses from my local florist, aka Zippy Paws. I recommend shopping local. However, you can order flowers online, or if you're in a pinch, your local supermarket always has flowers. While it's important to keep them watered, try not to drew on them too much. Tip number 3 is buy some candy. You can never go wrong with candy. It's cheap and super fun. I went with the classic conversation hearts, mostly because I have trouble expressing myself. I got mine from Chewy, and they come with a squeaker inside, but you can literally find candy anywhere. You probably have some in that one drawer in your kitchen that's stuffed with junk, but you should buy some new candy because nobody wants your green and red Christmas M&Ms. Tip number 4, always include a card, a note, or a love letter. I went with a paw written, love poem for that personal touch. Roses are red, violets are blue, I trade all my treats for a date with you. Love, Norman. For the record, I would not trade my treats for anyone, but you're allowed certain creative liberties when writing Valentine's letters, so have fun with it. Now for the scary part. I'm going to put these tips into action and ask out my crush, Miss Pinky. There she is, guys. What? No, I'm not stalking her. I'm just watching her from afar without her knowing. Fine, I'll go talk to her. Hey, Miss Pinky. We've known each other now for a few months, and I was wondering if you would like to get some lunch and watch a movie with me? I heard Pets 2 is pretty good. Yes? Yay! She said yes, guys. Wow, my tips worked. I can't believe she said yes. Everything's happening so fast. I feel like we're going to live happily ever after. Right, Miss Pinky? Miss Pinky? Miss Pinky, where'd you go? What the? You're dating Larry now? What does he have that I don't? Don't judge me. I give Valentine's Day 1 paw because Pets 2 was actually pretty good and I got to eat some ice cream. If you like what you saw, give me a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and check out my other videos. Thanks for watching, and have a happy Valentine's Day. See y'all next week. Love, Norman.